Hey everyone, welcome back. Welcome back to the channel. My name's Grant. I'm a freelance photographer and graphic designer based in Queensland, Australia. And in today's video, we're going to talk about building up a professional Micro Four Thirds kit, okay, for professional work, okay? This is a question that I've been asked a lot lately on the channel. People seem to be very interested in the concept of Micro Four Thirds, in particular Panasonic cameras used for professional work, paid client gigs, okay? So let's roll that intro and let's get straight into it. Hey everyone, welcome back. So yeah, Micro Four Thirds for professional work. Building up a kit so you can start to make some money, okay? Let's get one thing out of the way first. That Micro Four Thirds, in particular the Panasonic cameras, are more than capable for professional work, okay? And we're going to focus more on photography with Panasonic Lumix. You know, it's pretty well known that the GH5, you know, really carved its way into, like, you know, the world of video, and, you know, a lot of professional videographers use that camera and still do use that camera. They've now, you know, potentially a lot of them have moved onto the GH6 or the GH5 Mark II, like I have. But that camera really was great for professional work, and it really paved the way for Lumix and, you know, its name in the professional video world, right? However, photography, not so much. It's not known a lot for professional photography. I've been using Panasonic cameras since 2017, switching over from Nikon DSLRs. So since that point, I've been using Panasonic cameras for professional work, Micro Four Thirds, you know, for the last however many years it's been. And I've had no issues whatsoever. I've always got the files in and I've been paid, right? So we're just going to go over a whole heap of things, really, but we're just going to focus mainly on cameras and the lenses. We're not going to worry about, like, batteries and lights and flashes and tripods and bags. It's really just about building up a camera kit and a lens kit, okay? So let's get into it. Okay, so let's get into cameras first, right? So when I first started shooting professionally and I started getting paid with, which is with my Lumix gear, even with my Nikon gear, I always had two cameras, okay? So when I switched over to the Panasonic, I had a GX8 and a G7. They were my main two cameras, okay? I always had two cameras in the bag just in case one camera or my A cam packed it in on the gig. I could keep shooting by picking up my B cam, okay? So that's the most important thing, okay? Tip number one, or, you know, strongly, strongly recommend, have two cameras in your bag at all time, okay? For your A cam, I do recommend, if you have the budget, is getting something like a G9 or a GH5 or GH5 Mark II or even a GH6 if you've got the budget for that. That camera is fantastic. Why I say that is that for your A cam, you want something that is on the higher tier of the Panasonic cameras, in my opinion. Why? Redundancy. All those cameras I mentioned, they all have two card slots, okay? So you're shooting and you're backing up your images and your video all the time. If one card slot packs it in, you've got your images, you've got your video on the other card slot too. It's all about redundancy, okay? So, you know, and the higher end cameras like the G9, GH5, those sort of things, they've all got more pro features too. More tactile dials, more button options, more profiles, especially the GH5 Mark II. The picture profiles on that thing is incredible. You've just got more options on a higher level camera like a G9 or GH5. So A cam, you know, strongly recommend getting something a little bit more professional. But in saying that, if you're just starting out, it's all well and good just to start with any sort of Micro Four Thirds camera, just as long as you got two. Let's talk about now the B cam, the second camera in the bag. Okay, so for me, I've always got two cameras in the bag. I started out with a GX8, G7. They were my main two cameras. Then I got a G9 and the GX8 become my B cam. I sold the GX8, got a GX9, that became my B cam. Then I sold the GX9 and got the GH5 Mark II, and that was going to be my A cam, and the old G9 was going to be my B cam. But I've ended up keeping my GH5 Mark II as my main YouTube camera. I want it permanently set up at all times. So that led me, you know, my golden rule is that you've always got to have two cameras in the bag, okay? So I wanted to stay with Panasonic, obviously, because I've got all the lenses and stuff. So my B cam is now the G85. Great, awesome little camera. You can definitely do professional work with this camera. Is it one of their professional cameras? Not really, right? But you can definitely get paid using this camera, okay? One of the main reasons I got this camera too is also the size factor, okay? It's not as bulky as the G9 or the GH5. So having these two cameras in the kit is not going to take up, in the bag I should say, is not going to take up as much room, right? That's another reason I got it. Sticking with the Panasonic ecosystem as well, you know, I know what I'm going to get with it when it comes to files and photos and video, colors, tones, all that sort of thing. Working in Lightroom, working in Photoshop, I'm working with the same kind of file at all times. So we've got 20 megapixel sensor and my B cam is a 16 megapixel sensor. Doesn't really matter for me anyway. The main thing is it's that mental sort of thing where I got, well, okay, I've got another camera in my bag just in case the A cam goes down. I won't look like an idiot on the gig and I'll still get paid. So yeah, G85 is my B cam, okay? Obviously you can see there is a bit of a trend with this where, you know, the main thing is you have two cameras in the bag. You're getting paid, have two cameras in the bag. Even if you get your A cam, you got a G9, you've spent all your money on a G9 or a GH5, go and buy a secondhand G85, go and buy a secondhand G7, you know, a GX85, something like that. You just got to have that separate camera in the bag. That's enough about that. I think I've drilled that home to you. Let's get on to lenses. Okay, lenses. So, you know, if you've bought your G9, G85, G7, whatever it is, you know, you're probably going to end up with like a kit lens, okay? So we all start with the kit lenses and we grow from there. I'm currently filming on a kit lens, the 12-60. A variable aperture lens. I think it's great. Would I use it for professional work? Yeah, if I had to, no worries whatsoever. But you know, start at your kit lens and then sort of grow from there, okay? One of the main lenses I do recommend people get for when they're building up a professional kit is a Nifty 50. And what I mean by that is, on the Micro Four Thirds mount, it's something like a 25 mil focal length, okay? So this is a 50 mil focal length and it's a prime lens, okay? So it's a fixed focal length. Starting out with something like this and growing from there is a really, really good way of building and developing your Micro Four Thirds lenses, okay? So this 25 is absolutely brilliant. This is the cheaper one. This is just the Lumix 25mm f1.7. Leica make a version of this. It's a 1.4. I do believe I will be getting that lens fairly soon because I'm loving this lens here. This is, for me, this is pretty much a new sort of piece of kit in the lens. I got it with my G85 in my lens kit. So yeah, starting out 25 Nifty 50, that's a good way to go. You then can maybe look at getting, if you've got a Nifty 50, maybe a versatile zoom. So you could look at potentially getting maybe Panasonic Leica 12-60. This is a variable aperture, so it's a bit slower than the other faster lenses. F2.8 to F4. This is a really good option. Starting out with two lenses like this, a Nifty 50 prime lens. This is going to be great for portraiture, product work. Oh man, pretty much everything. You can pretty much glue this on your camera and you'll be right. And then maybe getting something like a zoom that's got a good range of focal lengths is another good idea too. If you want to upgrade from that lens here, the 12-60, maybe looking at some of the higher end Lumix lenses, in particular the 35-100 or its little brother, the 12-35. Those two lenses have a constant f2.8 aperture, so they're better in low light conditions and things like that. They're two good lenses. You could pretty much do a lot of professional work if you had this 35-100 or and the 12-35mm f2.8 lenses and a G9 and your backup camera. You could pretty much do everything, okay? They're fast lenses when it comes to micro four thirds. They give great results. They got great compression. You're going to cover all your bases by getting something like that, right? So that's a good way to start. Then you can probably look at maybe, you know, you start making a little bit more money with your micro four thirds kit. All those lenses there, they start out from cheapest to more expensive. So the Nifty 50, this thing's about $200 Australian. Then you sort of work up from there. The 12 to 60 is probably about just over 1,000 new. The 12 to 35 is just over 1,000 new. And the 35 to 100 is just over 1,000 new, all in Australia, right? So it's a little bit more of an investment, but once you start making a little bit more money, you might want to look at some other primes, okay? Such as the Panasonic Leica 12mm. This is a 24mm full frame equivalent lens, f1.4. This is a great prime lens too. This is going to cover a lot of bases. You can do a lot of stuff with this one. Then you could look at the mother of all micro four third lenses and the 42.5 f1.2. This lens is, well, it's pretty much glued to my G9 at all times. For professional work, it doesn't get much more professional than this lens. You know, if you bought this and added this to your kit, you really are future-proofing your micro four thirds mount and system, okay? This thing will give you great results. Other prime lenses you could look at, the 15mm f1.7, as I mentioned before, the 25mm f1.4. Any Panasonic Leica lens is really going to give you great results. So, you know, what you do is you start out with your kit lens and then you grow from there, okay? Your kit lens will get you out of trouble. When I first moved over to Panasonic from Nikon, obviously I only had the kit lenses and I was doing work with it straight away, okay? So it can be done. Once you go through all your Panasonic Leica lenses, Lumix lenses, don't forget that the Olympus lenses do fit on the Micro Four Thirds Panasonic mount as well. So, you know, something like the 12 to 40 f2.8, that lens is fantastic. You know, you got options there as well. I personally prefer the results of sticking with Panasonic and Panasonic, Lumix with Lumix, okay? Leica with Lumix. I just feel like the colors and the look just look better, okay? You know, once you want to do all that sort of stuff, you can start experimenting. So this is a 7 Artisans 35mm f 1.4 manual lens. This lens is a lot of fun. I don't use it on professional work for photography. I always stick with the autofocus. It's great. It's a lot of fun. This lens was really good on the GX9 for street photography. I don't use it that much. I probably will sell it soon, but yeah, that's another good option as well. Experimenting with those cheaper Chinese-made lenses is really cool. Another option you can do, and I used to do this a lot, I still do, is adapting lenses, okay? So adapting Canon glass to Lumix lenses. All my Canon glass is at my brother's house at the moment. He's got a 6D Mark II that he's using, so he's borrowed all my Canon lenses. But, you know, adapting Canon lenses to this, in particular, the 24-105 f4, that lens on the G9, oh man, the results that gives is absolutely brilliant. I'll try to put a few photos in here, but you know, don't rely on the autofocus. It's not too bad. The stills, not good for video, definitely not. More manual sort of focus, but the results you get is definitely worth it, okay? So again, getting something like a speed booster, adapting your Canon glass, is a really, really good option too, okay? And again, you know, the speed booster will fit on all micro four thirds mounts, so I can adapt my Canon glass to my G85. I think I've said that a few times in the video. Adapting lenses too is another good option to build up and give you a little bit more variety too, okay? So there, There you go. You know, just to recap, this video's gone a bit longer than my usual videos. Just to recap, my main point is that when you're building up a professional Micro Four Thirds kit, you definitely want to have two cameras in your bag if you're doing paid client work. You want that redundancy factor. Your A cam, preferably something a little bit more professional in the Panasonic lineup, like a G9 or a GH5. Two card slots, weather sealed, all that sort of stuff, customization, just more pro features. Your B cam doesn't have to be, of course, if you've got two Lumix G9s. I know a lot of my subscribers do have two G9s. Great. But you don't need, you know, another high-end camera as your B cam. Something like, you know, a G85 would be fine. G7, GX9, perfect, right? So two cameras is the most important thing. Then you move across, you've got your lenses, you start developing your lenses and buying more lenses as you start making more money. Start out with your kit lenses, then move into maybe getting some Lumix primes like the 25mm, the 42.5 f1.7, that's another great light little lens, fantastic. Growing from there, maybe getting a couple of cool, fast, versatile zoom lenses like the 12-35 is a good option, the 12-60, if you need a bit more length, the 35-100. You start making a little bit more money, you start investing in maybe some more Panasonic Leica lenses like the 12mm f1.4, 42.5, 15mm, 1.7, 25mm f1.4. You start to develop your kit, then you can start experimenting. You got a little bit more money to spend, well, you might want to start experimenting with some Chinese lenses. Then for me, what I really enjoyed doing was using speed boosters and adapting my old Canon lenses. Of course, I had a bit of Canon gear from, you know, a previous life when I used to shoot Canon, and adapting those old lenses to the G9, the GH5, awesome results, okay? So, yeah, if you've got any questions, please leave them down below. If you like this sort of content, please feel free to subscribe to the channel. And yeah, I'll see you all next time. Bye.